Let's talk about why most bloggers fail and how to make sure that you are not one of them. I'm going to show you in this video. So Andrea Bolder here from AndreaBolder.com, where I help bloggers prep for profits and build powerful businesses online. So you're watching this video because you have really decided to take the leap and to start that blog of yours, but you are trying to figure out how not to jack it all up, how not to start something and then struggle. So I was reading this article the other day and it had this crazy stat that said that the number of bloggers in the United States is set to reach 31.7 million users by the year 2020. But you know, the harsh reality is that the majority of these blogs are or will be, for lack of a better word, failures. In fact, most people who start their blogs, they are going to quit within the first 3 months. Oh my gosh, the first 3 months. But why? Was their idea not good enough? Was their motivation and excitement not big enough? Was their desire to succeed not strong enough? You know, when entrepreneurs decide to take on the path of entrepreneurship, when they decide to embark on this journey of entrepreneurship, of starting their own business, starting their own blog, they probably expect that the journey will be filled with some ups and downs. I mean, that is to be expected when you are embarking on anything new. But I don't think any blogger goes into building their brand, building their blog, building their online business thinking, hey, in 3 months, I'm gonna fail, right? But time and time again, I see it. I see big dreams and excitement. It wears off, the excitement is gone, and what's left is frustration and overwhelm and doubt and regret. So what can we do to beat the odds? Or maybe a better question is, what can we do to ensure that we are going to be successful? You know, most bloggers will start their blogs off with the best of intentions, but they will fall off because they waste their time on pointless activities that do not deliver what they really want and what they really need to be able to succeed in their business. That means getting more traffic, getting more customers, and making more money. If you don't have those things, you cannot build a profitable or a successful business. And, you know, they put all of their time, all of their energy, all of their resources into building the perfect blog, creating the most beautiful social media profile pages and Instagram pages and Facebook pages. And they build out awesome products, which are all very important. But they spend all of their time in the first few months perfecting these things before they actually launch. And something strange happens. They'll waste those first 3 months, the first 4 months, the first 6 months of their business, making everything look pretty, doing, you know, every little thing to ensure that they appear like a business, but not really doing the things to be a business. And they're doing very little to jumpstart their profits. And they'll have nothing to show for all of the hard work that they put in over the past few months, but a bunch of, you know, social media logins, passwords, and the belief that I'll be ready to go when I just finish this one thing, or I'll be ready to launch when I just get this one more thing completed. And it's the lack of results that will demotivate even the most ambitious entrepreneur. And the more time that you spend working on something without reaping any benefits or reaping the rewards or seeing the fruits of your labor, you know, the harder it is going to be for you to continue doing it. I mean, it's insane to keep knocking your head against the wall, not getting the results that you want, and then to keep doing the things that are not getting you the results. That's the definition of insanity. And that's why I believe most bloggers fail. They continue to do things that don't reap the rewards that they're looking for. And then one day they just throw their hands up and say, you know what, I'm done. So how can we fix that? Well, what I want to do is I'm going to break down three simple solutions, or give you three simple suggestions that you can start implementing or at least thinking about as you are embarking on your entrepreneurial journey. And the first thing is you need to promote more and publish less. So as a blogger, as a business owner, the natural thing to do is to sit down in front of your computer and start cranking out content. Bloggers blog, right? So what's the problem with this? Creating content is a waste of time if no one actually sees what it is that you're creating. When you run a blog that gets little to no traffic, creating more content is not going to help you get more readers or more visitors or make you more sales unless you are promoting that content. The key to building a successful blog lies in your ability to promote the content that you already have and to promote your content in the right ways. So just think about this. McDonald's is not going to make more hamburgers just for the sake of making more hamburgers in the hopes that they sell. They are going to focus on making more commercials. They are going to focus on finding more ways to grow their brand. They're going to focus on getting their name out there in front of more people so that they can get their burgers in front of more people. The promotion drives the profits, not the product itself. So you don't have to create content all day. You don't have to, even though you're a blogger, you don't have to sit down in front of your computer and say, I'm going to write a blog post every single day. You just have to work on getting the content that you already have out there and in front of more people. So the next thing that I want you to focus on is being more creative and less cookie cutter. You cannot copy and paste your way to a profitable blog. If you want to grow an audience, one that sticks, one that will provide for you a loyal and raving customer base, then you've got to create a blog and a blog experience that is unique and one of a kind, something that people just can't find anywhere else online or from anyone else. You know, most blogs are in fact what I call cookie cutter. They're cookie cutter blogs. They say the same things, they teach things in the same way as everyone else, and there is nothing that differentiates them or sets them apart from all the other millions of blogs that are out there or the other millions of other people in that same industry that you may be in that are teaching and training and trying to grab the same audience that you are. And if you want to be remembered, you have to be able to find a way to stand out. And it's really that simple. So how can you actually stand out from all of the other millions of bloggers out there in your niche? Well, what you need to do is you need to get really, really specific about who you are, what you stand for, what your blog stands for, and what you bring to the table that is unique and fresh and new and innovative and creative and visionary and out of the box. You have to be unique and you have to be able to stand alone in an industry that is very crowded and noisy. So for example, if you are a fitness blogger and you can go on YouTube and put in fitness blogger, and I guarantee you, thousands and thousands, probably millions of hits will come up. So if you're a fitness blogger, don't write about fitness, write about fitness for new moms who want to get their bikini bodies back. If you are a beauty blogger, don't just write about beauty tips. You know, don't be generic. Write about beauty tips for ethnic skin tones. You have to find a way to get very specific and to stand out and to carve out a niche where you are at the top and there is little to no competition. Okay, you're eliminating the competition because you are creating your own lane. So look, getting specific is not narrowing your reach. It's about owning your reach and becoming a master in your market. I mean, what's more memorable? I'm a fitness blogger, or I can show you how to get your sexy body back after you have a baby. Okay, so focus on that special thing, that something that only you have, that you can only convey and teach and train others or teach others in your own unique way. So the last thing that I really want you to consider and focus on is to have more patience and focus less on rushing the process. I know it is totally normal to want to see results fast. You want to grow your audience fast. You want to build your email list fast. You want to multiply your sales and be rich fast and build this entire huge empire fast, fast, fast. Okay, believe me, I get it. But things not going as fast as you expected them doesn't mean giving up. It doesn't mean letting go of your dreams because things are not coming to fruition in the timetable or the timeline that you wanted them to. But this is what I really want you to concentrate on. You know, things are not going to go as fast as you expect them. And that doesn't mean that you need to drop what it is that you're doing or give up on yourself. A couple of years into my own entrepreneurial journey, I had come to the realization that there's no magic pill. There's no shortcut to success. And if I really wanted to make my dreams a reality, I was going to have to go out there and work harder, work longer, be stronger, more disciplined, more focused, and do all of these things in a way that I've never done before, because this is a new experience for me. And I was going to have to go out there and figure out a system to success that worked for me and my business. You have to be committed to the process. I mean, insanely over the top, focused and disciplined, and you cannot be afraid to roll up your sleeves and get dirty. You have to be able to, if you're going to grow your business, you have to be able to dive in and say, I'm going to work as hard as I need to get the results that I want. You cannot escape the hard work. Success is what you find when you let go of all those excuses, right? And you have to believe that your dreams are worth working for. And it's that belief, the belief in your business, the belief in your mission, the belief in your vision that you have been baking in your mind and in your heart and in your soul for years, maybe even, decades. And it's the belief in the impact that you can make with your blog and with your business. It's the belief in yourself that will ultimately fuel you towards figuring it all out. So, are you willing to work at it even when you're tired, even when the results are not there quite yet, even when you lack the motivation and the willpower to, dig deep? Are you willing to say, I'm going to hang on one more day? I'm going to keep going one more day. I'm going to take one more step or stay up one more hour. You know, successful bloggers keep going. They keep hanging on even when everyone else has given up and thrown in the towel. But that's not going to be you, right? So you see, the funny thing about success is that the formula is going to be different for everyone. What works for everyone else may not work for me. What works for me may not work for you. And while I encourage you to invest in trainings, invest in courses, seek mentorship and study your craft, I also want you to know that it's you and only you that can create the blueprint to success for your business, because your business is not going to be built and it's not going to do, it's not going to reach, it's not going to come to fruition like anybody else's business. It is unique to you and your vision. You can't copy and paste your way to the top. You can't rely solely on the experiences and the expertise of others. And you can't be afraid to figure some things out on your own. So with all that said, your success is here for the taking. It's here for you to have and to hold. The only question that you have to ask yourself is, am I willing to do whatever it takes to make it happen? So if you're ready to take your blog from broke to making bank online, make sure that you download the freebie below for more actionable advice and business tips.